here to celebrate two heroes of the marriage equality movement, Jim Obergefell and Mary Bonauto. As well as to celebrate the ACLU's decades-long campaign to win the freedom to marry for same-sex couples. To some folks, it may seem like it was a quick victory, but make no mistake, it took nearly half a century and was the result of the work of countless individuals and many organizations.
Jim Obergefell and his husband, John Arthur, had been together since the early 1990s. They met three times before the sparks flew. It was love at third sight. But in 2011, John was diagnosed with ALS, and over the next couple of years, Jim cared for John until his death in 2013. Now, having suffered that devastating loss, Jim could well have mourned privately. But instead, he chose to stand up for equality and dignity for himself and for John and for the many other LGBT couples who had been excluded from marriage by Ohio and other states. And the same is true of all the plaintiffs in the cases that reached the Supreme Court, whom we also honor tonight. The other beneficiary of this year's award is Mary Bonauto, the attorney who argued for Jim and the other plaintiffs before the U.S. Supreme Court. Mary did an amazing job of telling the plaintiffs' stories and making the legal argument for marriage equality. And I have to say, she fielded some pretty off-the-wall questions from a few of the justices that would have thrown a less able advocate off her game. But Mary was unfazed. But the Obergefell case is the tip of the iceberg of Mary's contribution to the marriage equality movement. Mary is one of the main architects of that movement. She filed and argued the first case that won marriage equality in any state in the U.S., the Goodridge case in Massachusetts in 2004. She won marriage equality in Connecticut's High Court in 2009, and then worked on legislative and ballot measure initiatives that achieved marriage equality in all of the New England states. She filed the first major challenge to the Federal Defense of Marriage Act and played a pivotal role in the Windsor case, in which the Supreme Court struck down the federal DOMA in 2013. And through all of that, Mary helped other advocates behind the scenes, including myself, in cases around the country. Mary's incredibly humble, she's tireless, and most important, she's effective. I now present Ramona Ripston, James Obergefell, and Mary Bonauto.
Because keeping at it is what all of us must do. Clearly, we won one of the biggest battles ever in this movement, but the larger fights for justice loom large. The Supreme Court, along with the hard work, love, and truth-telling of millions of people, including many people in this room, made the freedom to marry the law of the land. But 100 million Americans need to still wake up and smell the equality. Just look at Congress. After the Obergefell decision, did they rush in to say, we need to make the Equality Act a top priority? No. Now there's an effort, actually, to pass a wide-ranging religious veto for those who object to our very existence. June's ruling is the fourth Supreme Court ruling in 20 years, saying in essence, treat gay people and same-sex couples the way you treat all others. In a rational world, everyone should have gotten the memo. But that's not the world we live in. Now, it's easy sometimes to live in a little gay bubble. We cannot do that. Obergefell, in particular, has made us part of the world. Now is the time to reach out to those who don't support us, to talk and also to listen so that everyone understands that our struggle is about making America a land where all people can work, love, grow up in peace and happiness with full freedoms and opportunities. The Obergefell decision said, the Constitution grants us equal dignity, and it does. But no one hands you your equal dignity. You have to fight for it. Gay and lesbian advocates and defenders is proud to have a close relationship of fighting together with the ACLU. And I am deeply moved and grateful that this Southern California affiliate has been fighting anti-gay bias since before Stonewall. That leadership took focus with Ramona Ripston, continues with Hector Viagra, and is enriched by your support and generosity. There is one path forward and no turning back. The Ramona Ripston Liberty, Justice, and Equality Award validates what we have done and inspires all of us to do more. Thank you.
It's a great pleasure to be here and be recognized with this wonderful award. Ramona has dedicated her life to the ACLU in fighting for our constitutional rights, and I'm honored to be recognized with an award that carries her name. Thank you, Ramona, for your decades of hard work for such an important organization. We owe you a debt of gratitude for all you've accomplished. And Mary, I'm humbled to share in the honor of the Ramona Ripston Award with you. I can never thank you enough for your tireless work on Obergefell v. Hodges. It was a great honor for me to hear you argue in the United States Supreme Court for our constitutional right to marry. Thank you, Mary, for fighting for my marriage and for so many others. Just over 2 years ago, the ACLU joined a marriage equality case in Cincinnati, Ohio. My late husband John and I brought that case against the city of Cincinnati and the state of Ohio to demand recognition of our lawful out-of-state marriage. We wanted our marriage recorded on John's impending death certificate. You see, 2 weeks after the Windsor decision struck down part of the Defense of Marriage Act, I married John, the love of my life, aboard a medical jet on the tarmac at the Baltimore-Washington International Airport. We married on a medical jet because John was dying of ALS, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease, and he was bedridden in at-home hospice care and nearing the end of his life at the age of 47. But we couldn't marry at home in Cincinnati, where John would be safe and comfortable, because of a state constitutional amendment that banned same-sex marriage. John and I had promised to love, honor, and protect each other over the course of our 21 years together, and we were thrilled to finally make those commitments public and legal. We had no plans to do anything else. No plans to file a lawsuit. No plans to begin a fight that would have such far-reaching consequences. All we wanted was simply to live out John's remaining days as husband and husband, not legal strangers. 5 days after we were married, friends introduced us to Al Gerhardstein, a civil rights attorney in Cincinnati. In our very first meeting, Al pulled out a blank death certificate, showed it to us, and said, "Do you realize, guys, that when John dies, his last official record as a person will be incorrect? Ohio will say he's unmarried, and Jim, your name won't be listed as his surviving spouse." Our hearts broke, but more importantly, we got angry. So we filed suit in federal district court, and we won. John died 3 months to the day after that ruling, and the state of Ohio eventually appealed. And I continued that fight because I had to live up to my commitments to love, honor, and protect John. I simply had no other option. I'd made promises to John that I needed to keep. And you all know how that's turned out.